कृष्णा, गौर सिंधु गोपीनाथ प्रभु दंडवत प्रणाम। हरे
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण
कृष्णा श्री भगवत प्रभु दंडवत प्रणाम प्रभु जी।
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु जी
हरे कृष्णा माता जी दंडवत प्रणाम।
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु हाउ आर यू प्रभु।
आई एम गुड थैंक यू सो मच। प्लीज प्लीज
यस प्रभु जी।
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, we can start Prabhu. So good morning all devotees, Dandavat Pranam, welcome to the Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Today we are very happy to have the association of His Grace Gaurachand Gopinath Prabhu. He will be sharing Katha from Prabhupada Lilamrita, chapter 13, Butler, Pennsylvania, the first testing ground. Over to you Prabhuji.
Yeah, thank you very much Prabhu. Also you can allow me to share my presentation.
Yeah, you have been given co-host rights, so you should be able to share.
You are able to see the screen, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu.
ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया सक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देगं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुधापदकमलं श्रीगुरोन्वैष्णवां च श्रीरूपं साग्रजादां सगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सगण लीला श्रीविशाखान्वितं च। नमो ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमदे भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशधारिणे महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रतायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिने गौरतिशे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानो सुधे देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाशादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। I seek all the Vaishnavas' blessings so that you know we can discuss something on Prabhupada Lilamrita, chapter 13. It is entitled Butler, Pennsylvania, the first testing ground. So now, so far we have seen that Prabhupada has come to the, he came to the shore, onshore, and all the formalities being done. Now he was sponsored by this family, the Butler, in the Butler, the Agarwal family. So we're going to see today entire narration of how Prabhupada stayed in their house, how he is first accustomed to the, you know, the US. He's trying to see the first time what's happening around it. So it is a narration of in the house of the Gopal Agarwal, who is the sponsor. So we will see the details today. So this is a letter from so this is an expert from Sumati Morarji letter. Prabhupada was writing it as soon as he landed. So he was, Prabhupada was invited actually there in Butler to speak to some churches and some colleges, schools. And the students were really receptive. But the churches, all these people in the church, they felt, you know, uncomfortable because he might convert them to, you know, Hinduism or something like that. Because they never seen before, like anybody who's coming from India and preaching like that. So that's where Prabhupada writes. They do not know that devotional service of the Lord Krishna is the common religion for everyone, including even the aborigines and the cannibals in the jungle, from a letter to Sumati Morarji. So this is the first time trying to Prabhupada, you know, trying to preach or speak to the small group in colleges. And we see how Prabhupada succeeds in that. So in the bottom of the picture, there are three pictures in this slide. One is that Prabhupada, how he started cooking in Sally's house. And we will see more detail. And there's a lot of interesting things. And Prabhupada, and you can see this Ambarla, which is something special. Prabhupada had a typewriter with this Ambarla, and you would have a wear one cap. So it's looked very, you know, interesting to the people around the neighborhood to see Prabhupada carrying all these things. And that was Sally's son, Rich. He was a very small boy. And Prabhupada is how he became a very easy guest, Sally remembers. And the bottom, you can see this gray hound. This is the bus Prabhupada is taking from here to go to the Butler, because in the midtown of Manhattan, so Prabhupada has to take a bus to go to the Pennsylvania where the Butler is staying. So Gopal had arranged a bus because he can't come to the New York. So somewhere in the Manhattan, they arranged for the bus. This bus, there is an aide, people who can put them in proper buses. So somebody came and received Prabhupada, and they try, they onboarded him to the place where Gopal is living. And from Gopal would receive him and he will take him to his house. So Prabhupada is on his own. So the travel team arranged to take a bus. So Prabhupada first time looking at these skyscraper buildings in the Manhattan. And this is the Lincoln Tunnel, the famous tunnel. And he was trying to see all this Western culture, first time Prabhupada trying to experience this. So the bus is, he's onboarded, and is Prabhupada witnessing this such a magnitude for the first time. See, the American culture was based on passion and sense gratification, and it was sense of madness. Because Prabhupada was looking at the highways, the cars were going at 60 miles per hour here and there, zooming, and Prabhupada was thinking, what kind of people, why people are rushing so mad for breakneck speed? And he could see that why people are going, this is all advertised in the billboards, because people are after the sense gratification, nothing else. So Prabhupada also trying to know, in the book, Satswarup Maharaj writes that, so how in Vrindavan, Prabhupada would have seen, you know, bulla carts, at the worst case when travels highway, there's no billboards. People used to know village and they used to do household activities like that. But Prabhupada, you know, people would chant Jai Radhe, Hare Krishna, like that. You see in this village of Vrindavan, even New Delhi when you would have come to. But this is something like a scale at which Manhattan was built, the skyscraper buildings, the highways, the people busy going. And Prabhupada was just thinking, what kind of passion here? And also Prabhupada knows that unless one comes out of this mode of passion, sinful activities, one cannot become take Krishna consciousness. He saw huge billboards on the way. You know what it was talking? It's talking about meat eating, intoxication. And there is a very beautiful woman giving advertisement, eating in the restaurants. Oh, this kind of billboards was looking. And Prabhupada was thinking, he came to preach the opposite. What are billboards are there? People are running around so busy for it. And Prabhupada is going to speak against it, or he wants to teach the opposite of it, how one should come out of the mode of passion. So Prabhupada is looking at, thinking like this, then Satswarup Maharaj explains in the Lilamrita that we have seen Prahlad Maharaj. He was a Goshtyanandi, is not a Bhajanandi. So here mainly many saintly person we have seen, they are very interested in own deliverance. They go and do some Himalayas or somewhere, they go to the very secluded place, then they start meditating. But they are not interested in delivering others, especially in the city. So Prahlad Maharaj says, I don't want to go alone. I want to take all these poor fools and rascals without which I can't come. So similar mood was Prabhupada's. He would have happily lived in Vrindavan, but he left everything, doesn't know anyone, but he's still taking a risk to save all these people. So this is the place after short travel. It was midnight. Prabhupada was traveling. It is almost past midnight, 1 o'clock. He reaches the Pittsburgh area. This is where Gopal Agarwal would pick him, and another 1 hour drive to the Butler place. So this is a wonderful river, Allegheny River. This is where the city is located, Pittsburgh. And you can see on the picture, right, topmost corner, there is one old elderly person and there is one fat person, young person. The elderly person is Gopal Agarwal. He is the one who was waiting. He arranged all this bus facility from New York, Manhattan to pick him up to come Pittsburgh. So then he welcomes Swamiji, Prabhupada. Then he takes him in his car. That was the younger person is the son who was 3 years old or less than 3 years old. He was started walking when Prabhupada was there. It has become a big celebration in the house of Sally. So this boy was very, very small, 3-4 months old like that. And they visited in Mumbai. That's the time this picture was taken in Jugu. So like that. So what was going on in Gopal's mind is that they never expected Swamiji to come. His father would arrange many letters. He would ask many sponsorship. They have done it. But 3-4 days back, Prabhupada sends his photo and says that I'm arriving Boston in 4 days. This is my picture. So please arrange for me, accommodation like that. So they were got a shock. They never expected Prabhupada would arrive like that. So they saw this photo, then they was really surprised, the strange looking, because they never seen any sannyasi before like that in saffron who would come. But anyhow, he came and in his Volkswagen and he drove from here, Prabhupada, to his house. So Prabhupada reaches early morning at 4 a.m. In the Butler, Pennsylvania. So this is the place where it was explained that the American jeeps were all manufactured. So this is a signboard, and Prabhupada came at 4. He was really tired. And in the couch, they made him to sleep. He had a small living house, a dining room, and the kitchen upstairs. There was a rooms. It was occupied by the two kids. That time they had two kids. One baby girl, 3 years old. And this is the son who is 3 months old, where Prabhupada used to play with him. So then they thought after 2 days, Prabhupada may not be comfortable here. And they booked a room in YMCA. That's a small youth kind of a place. Generally people would stay. Small room is available closer to their house. So they plan to put Prabhupada on the YMCA. Prabhupada is to stay in YMCA. But on a daily basis, he would come in the morning and evening to this butler's, Gopal Agarwal's place. And he would, cook and he would talk to the guest like that. So before we move on, I have a wonderful clipping, which I'll play. Let me know if you're not able to hear the sound. I will share it separately.
Sound is not coming, Guruji.
Sound is not coming?
Yes.
Okay. Just give me a second, Prabhu. I might need to play it separately.
Okay.
Share computer audio, Prabhu. It will play.
Where? Let me know if you are able to see now, this one. Is it okay?
You can see only Windows Explorer, Prabhuji.
Oh, sorry. Now, Prabhu?
No, Prabhu. We just see the folder.
Okay. Share it. Share. Share computer's audio. Okay.
Yes, Prabhu.
And he asked me to sponsor the swarm. That's what I did.
We didn't really think anything would come of agreeing to this proposition. I called my husband at work and I said, Gopal, honey, sit down. We just got a letter and that Swami is going to come to Boston in 4 days.
The Swami came with so few possessions. He came with the clothes he had on his back. He had a typewriter and he had his books. And he had a bag of cereal. Imagine coming to a country on the other side of the world with so little.
For his first night in America, he slept on the couch. Next morning, the children came downstairs and they were in shock, looking at this scary man with orange cloths on him. He loved the children. He played with them. And I could see it was a true love for them, not just fake stuff. Kamala, the older kid, she called him Swami Jesus. Called him Swami G. We thought that was so funny. He was a lot of fun, too. He would go shopping.
I think internet got disconnected for Prabhuji.
Yes, it looks like yes.
Sorry, there was a internet disconnect. Apologies.
No problem.
I don't know which one I was sharing. Okay.
Every day at 9 o'clock, you begin to prepare his lunch. In only
1 time. I think the video you're showing is just a snapshot, Prabhu. Is it playing on another window?
No, the audio is okay.
Audio is very feeble, but video is not playing. The audio is very low, Prabhu, at least in this video when compared to the previous one.
Okay, that's fine. So let's move on. So that's the first hand, like I just want to show Sally is talking about Prabhupada. Then we'll be covering it in the Lilamrita. So let me back to the PPT. So Sally is remembering Prabhupada, how it was a PC guest and Prabhupada. So whenever they saw the problem, like, you know, I said, accepting Prabhupada, it's not the place they would have stayed Prabhupada in their house, because the neighborhoods, what kind of a person was coming, you know, what would happen. So that's what the main concern for the family. So what's happening is whoever saw him, you know, in this orange robes, they were, you know, they were curious what's happening in Sally's house. So Sally had a plan. So what she said is, let us go and inform into the local newspaper so that everybody is aware what's happening. Otherwise, this strange looking person staying with them, she said to Prabhupada. Then they ran into a local newspaper, Pittsburgh, but they said, no, it's not important news. Then she went to the local other Butler Eagle. It's a local news magazine. And they given a interview so that Prabhupada information can be done. So the news article read, ambassador of the Bhakti Yoga. So this Butler Eagle has printed a photo. This Prabhupada holding a Srimad Bhagavatam, and he's given a post, and they pictured it, and the article was written, a Hindu devotee who comes to explain the mission, visit in the West. So like that, you know, and Prabhupada holding a Srimad Bhagavatam, and his written caption is ambassador of Bhakti Yoga. So then also they have described in detail, the article talks about a slight brown man in faded orange wraps and wearing a white bathing shoes, stepped out of a compact car yesterday and into the Butler YMCA to attend the meeting. He is His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swamiji, a messenger from India to the peoples of the West. This is the article read, and there are a lot of other information was given, and Prabhupada was explaining how human birth is very, very rare. If we miss this opportunity, again, they have to take the 84 lakh species of life. And he was requesting all the Americans pay more attention to the spiritual life. They would be happier. So what's happening is now, Sally is thinking, oh, he has just come to probably finance his books, then he will go away. They never thought that Prabhupada would start such a missionary activity. He would have huge followers. He doesn't want to meet. They thought, okay, he just came here. He would sell off, say, sponsor some books, then he would go away. And Prabhupada, you know, he just underplaying, because it was not his mode. He came here to preach the Krishna cult. But Prabhupada, never mind. He, you know, he said it's okay. And this is some this is on September 22nd. This is the newspaper which article came as soon as Prabhupada arrived. In 2 days' time, this September 22nd was Prabhupada. This article also talks about like how Prabhupada is like eating only vegetarian food and drinks milk, like that. And you can see in the picture, Prabhupada's the famous three-tier cooker on which he used to cook. And after some time, the family also used to it, and Prabhupada used to cook for Sally and his family as well. So what Sally is thinking, okay, you'll just come, you'll go, you know, after taking some sponsorship of the books. But Prabhupada slowly started asking her to kind of have an open house program, invite the neighborhoods, nearby neighbors, so that he can talk 6 to 9 in the evening. After insisting Prabhupada, then Sally said, okay, we can sort of have this kind of program. So there is a kind of intellectual group that around the Butler area. So there are a lot of middle-class people who came to hear and talk from Srila Prabhupada. So everywhere one was curious what's happening around this. So one time when they were discussing about Jesus, then somebody asked Prabhupada, what Swamiji, that time he was called Swamiji. Swamiji, what about Jesus? Prabhupada said, yes, Jesus is Son of God and he is the messenger. Similarly, I am the guest. I mean, Prabhupada saying himself, I am also son of God because I am also came here to preach to the whole world about the message of the God. So Prabhupada connects very nicely and he explains his situation, how like Jesus, he also want to preach to the entire world. So when Prabhupada was, how she was explaining her experience, how Prabhupada used to chant when she used to take care of the household activity. So she never has to, you know, think, okay, how do I manage Prabhupada? So he was CCA guest. So people would sometime would come and do smoke. And she had, Gopal had already told her, don't smoke in front of Prabhupada, at least as etiquette. And she knew it, but people would come and Prabhupada say, you know, never mind. So just forget it. So he was so easy going. Prabhupada tolerated so much thing. Gopal was telling that, you know, Prabhupada always wanted everyone to become a better human being. He did not force initially anything on us. So this is the things was happening initially when Prabhupada arrived in their house. This is kind of a daily schedule, what Prabhupada has followed. Wherever Prabhupada went, yeah, very systematic. He never changed, you know, it will be America or India. He had a particular prescribed work and prescribed schedule, and it's easy for everyone. So generally he would come from YMCA. That is a place where he stayed a couple of blocks away from the Sally's house. And he would walk and come by 7 a.m. And he would have his India, from India, he brought a lot of cereals. And he would little of that and take milk. That would be his breakfast. Then Gopal leaves to office at 7:45, something like that. Then Prabhupada start preparing his lunch preparation at 9:30. Then this is where Sally remembers how Prabhupada used to cook in the three-tier system, where the bottom one you would cook dal and the top one you would have rice and some vegetables steamed. And Prabhupada did not have a rolling pin for even making chapati rotis. Prabhupada used to make it with the hand. That time there's no rolling pin there. So she remembers then once Sally was so interested, then Prabhupada started cooking for them magnanimously for many days, lunch preparation. So he would 11:30 would finish off all the preparations. Then he would start having, Gopal would come the lunch at 12 p.m. Generally used to have sandwich. Then he started liking this food and Prabhupada used to cook feast for all of them. And they all have food in the lunch. And Prabhupada goes back and probably would have written or translated something 1 to 5 p.m. Then he would come back for the open house. That's where most of the guests would come and they would have an open chat. And people used to drink and Prabhupada coffee and other tea. Prabhupada used to just take milk at 9 p.m. That would be his lunch. Sorry, that would be his dinner. So he always had one-time meal and Prabhupada had morning milk or if required or in the evening milk. Then he goes back to YMCA at 10 p.m. After talking to the guest, Gopal would drop him off in the YMCA. So Prabhupada would help the cooking. He would see this frozen beans and Prabhupada liked it. Doesn't need to clean up. So there's so many vegetables. He would count all the vegetables in the fridge. So he would look at the vacuum cleaner, the famous vacuum cleaner story, pastime where he would inquire how does it work and Sally would explain. So he'd be so excited, like a kid. Prabhupada would get so used to the family that Sally started feeling like he's a father-in-law who has come, and she was so comfortable with it. And Prabhupada tolerated it. They would keep the meat and he would keep it aside his things, and people would smoke. Do everything, and Prabhupada said, think nothing of it, don't worry, you know. So he was such an easy guest. And you can see in the picture, Sally with her daughter, as well as the top one, which I've showed already with the son, Gopal. So Prabhupada and his family, you know, this bridge and this baby girl who is 3 years old, was very, very close. Prabhupada, you know, when this, he was a small boy, bridge, then he started standing on legs. So he celebrated, Prabhupada celebrated. One time he was started chewing Prabhupada's sandal. So you can see the fortune of this boy who can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada, sorry, the shoes and the dust from Prabhupada. So definitely is so blessed. And this little girl, she would always tell, she can't say Swamiji, then she'll say Swami Jesus. And Prabhupada says, yeah, you know, a little child shall lead them. Like Prabhupada would joke with this family, and this kid, both of them very close to Prabhupada. And like this, Prabhupada is very, very comfortable in Butler, playing with the genuineness. The video, probably you've not seen it. In the video, she says that Sally is very, very close, Prabhupada, very genuine love. Like that, she's explaining her experience. So now the preaching starts. Now Prabhupada is talking to the small people in the community near the neighborhoods. The evening open house started happening. So when this news article came published, this Slippery Rock State College, there was a person, Alan Larson. He has seen this advertisement. He's in the department of spiritualism. So he wanted to have Prabhupada. He thought he was staying in Sally's house. He called up, but he found that he was staying in YMCA. So they made an arrangement to speak in this college. Before that, Prabhupada has also spoken in a couple of places. He spoke in the Club of Lions Club of Butler. And they're also given the Lions Club, they have given recognized him and he gave a kind of a certificate. Prabhupada is to carry that and show some other places. And also he would spoke in the Y and the Saint Fidelis Seminary College in Pennsylvania. So he spoke in a couple of places. Then this is the major program where he's trying to do the Slippery Rock State College, where is this Professor Alan Larson has taken him. And Prabhupada was very simple. He was waiting in the YMCA front end and he drove a car. Prabhupada was taken in the car. Then he went to the place. And Prabhupada just without microphone, that time he just cross-legged sitting and chanted for a few times and started speaking for 15 minutes only. As the kids were, it's a period for the next. So he was very short. After that, Prabhupada was patiently waiting for his lecture. 1 o'clock was his lecture. And he would chant in the park, sitting there next to the college. So after that, Prabhupada gave a 1 hour lecture. And there is a person who is Mohan Sharma, who is one of the faculty member, taking Prabhupada's house. He gave some hot milk and dry fruits. After that, Prabhupada has come back to YMCA. This is the first preaching where Prabhupada went to the different places and started talking about it. So what happens after this was happening, he received a letter from Srimati Sumati Maharaji. So Prabhupada used to always communicate with her what's happening. He would keep updating about what's happening. And there is a famous letter. This is really struck Prabhupada. Return only after you have completed your mission. Now she started writing, I'm happy that you're getting your good health. Please, because when he came, landed only, they booked for his return ticket. 2 months after, 2 months was his visa time, and they have already planned to book the return ticket, which he has done it before moving from New York, Manhattan to this place. So which is all the formalities were done. So Prabhupada, then she was telling, take a good rest. And then she says that, I feel that you should stay there until you fully recovered from your illness and return only after you have completed your mission. Prabhupada was thinking he might go to New York sometime then see how preaching happens and he'll go back to India because his return ticket was booked. Then he read this statement, you have to finish only come after completing your mission. This is something Prabhupada struck, which he thought of moving out of this place because here there's no freedom for him to preach. As long as here it's a small neighborhood and Prabhupada first handed came to know how they're accepting his ascent, how they're receptive to the culture which he's talking about, how people are eager about it, whether they're able to follow or not. So all this kind of assessment Prabhupada's happening from his initial preaching. So then Prabhupada expressed that, I want to leave Butler. I want to go to New York City. Prabhupada, because you know that already 1 month passed away. He had everything seen initially how it works. Then he said he wants to leave. Sally was really heartbroken because she felt like a family member, like a father-in-law father who's taking care of her. And then Gopal has to clearly, you know, explain, give a lot of instruction to how to take a bath in the bus stand, because, you know, Prabhupada used to take many a times, as a Brahminical culture used to take many times bath. He told him how to use the coin, like that. So with a lot of coins and things like that, and you know, they are sending with a heavy hearted to New York City. So then it's a short stay, Prabhupada, then he moves on to the New York City. So this is a small description where Prabhupada would spend some of his time. And it's just not only that, Prabhupada kept his contact with Sally all the time. Prabhu, I'm switching out to the window. Please let me know if you are able to see the other screen.
Yes, yes, we can see. I mean, yes, the Chrome window we can see.
Okay. So I just like to read a couple of letters which he has written to Sally. See the determination of Prabhupada, how he could encourage her in the activity. Okay, let me read the in chronological order. So this is the letter on 19th November. So this all happening, Prabhupada was stayed in her house till October 15th or till October end. Then November month he started to the New York. He was staying in the Mishra's camp and used to write regularly to Prabhupada. So this little Swamiji, like, now is very interesting, and Prabhupada writes a detailed brief about his daughter calling him a Swamiji Jesus. I just read, so interesting this. I beg to thank you for your kind letter of the 16th instant. I have noted the contents carefully. I'm glad to learn that you had been to your parents' house for a few days and now you have returned home. I'm still more glad to learn that you are going to observe the third birthday of Miss Kamala. This is the baby girl, and Saturday next. On this occasion, I should have presented her some ornaments, but as I am a sannyasi, I can simply offer my blessing and for long life and good prosperity. She cannot now read, otherwise at least I should have presented my set of books, but you should set aside one set of my books for her future reading. So this is how Prabhupada does a book distribution. So wherever there's opportunity, Prabhupada heavily depending on the distributing these books. In fact, he sent his books to California and 25 sets to the particular publisher. Once they sell it, he wants to get money, more books he wants to distribute. So he was taking the help of Gopal. Gopal is to dispatch all of them to different places like that. So he remembers this wonderful interaction. So then I oblige to your good daughter for awarding me a good degree as Swami Jesus, which is actually a great honor for me. Sometimes the Lord speaks through the innocent child, and I take this honor as a sent by the Lord Jesus through an innocent child free from all formalities of the current society. Lord Jesus preached the message of God, and I have taken up the same mission, and it would be a good luck for me if I can follow the footprints of Lord Jesus, who preached the message of Godhead in spite of all persecution. So this is where Prabhupada compares Lord Jesus, and he's following this footstep, and he want to spread this Bhagavatam like Jesus, whatever difficulties taken, he also ready to take such a thing. So he would connect personally with her, and Prabhupada then starts with a business proposition with her. He says that one can become rich by, you know, just doing a business or on the landlordship. So Prabhupada here gives a practical tips how one can be, you know, investing on the land or doing some business. That's the way you can, you know, become, earn more money than spend it for Krishna consciousness. Then he gives a proposal saying that there's a property in New York, which is $100,000. Then you spend $20,000, you come over here, we'll start a restaurant. Then you will fetch a very good rent and, you know, like that. Then also Prabhupada says that I want to send me $40. I want to California, because Prabhupada had sent his books. In California, there's a lot of people want to read his books, but that is the other end of the US. It takes a lot of time. Prabhupada cannot go and his visa is expiring. like that. So this way he used to write many letters to Sally. And there is another interesting thing. You can understand how Prabhupada was struggling, which any of you will be reading it in the next chapter, but to just a glimpse of what is that Prabhupada is talking about. And he wonderfully connects as well with Sally. And he says that, you know, generally the sons would inherit the qualities of a mother, and the baby girl would inherit the father. You are an intelligent mother, you have inherited your father's capability. Similarly, your son also, you know, inherited your quality. And he says how he's become a naughty adventurous. I'm also a old, you're like your old son. At the old age, I also taken in some adventurous task. Prabhupada again continues his business deal. He was asking Sally to join his business, saying that let us start a restaurant. There is so much potency. There are so many people in the restaurant, and you loved my food. And here also people love my food. And I can introduce a lot of vegetarian thing. And Prabhupada is telling that you can come. I can make you comfortable. There's one lady who can take care of you, like that. But at the end, Prabhupada is telling his position, right? It's very, very heartening, like, no, to read this. So one thing is, yeah. Okay, this is this paragraph. So I am not very fixed up of what to do or not, because Prabhupada didn't know. So nothing is working out in New York. The first consideration is that I must be in New York at least for 10, 15 days more. Then deciding the publication affair, and then I may leave this place for India or California. But the place where I'm living now has so many inconveniences, which I do not wish to narrate in this small letter. Yes, I'm taking my meals once only for this inconvenience. In this evening, I'll take some milk and fruit, and nowadays, night being very long, I feel sometimes for this night starvation. Prabhupada has given so much. He was so determined that in midst of so much difficulties, which you will see in the next weeks, how Prabhupada is from after Butler is going to New York, how much struggle he has to go through. Prabhupada hardly, you know, could be able to eat, and you know, one time he's preparing his meal with a great struggle, and is living sustaining on milk and fruits. So there is one thing, even that he's trying to preach to Sally, saying that one time there was a power cut in New York, and the Prabhupada was explaining how people were so affected in the, you know, footpath and the tunnels and the subways, and people were just literally suffering. And Prabhupada was mentioning it, you will be surprised, know that I had taken help of old crude method of lightning by burning some vegetable oil and use a small bowl as a lamp to save myself from the extreme darkness. So there was a power cut and extreme darkness, and people were suffering, and Prabhupada somehow managed to get a bowl of use vegetable oil, and he just lit the lamp to save from his place. Because he can't even get the candle, then somebody has given him fruits and candle. This is how Prabhupada was struggling, and you would see most of them in such a thing. And Prabhupada says, you come out of this, you have a financial problem, you come over here, let us start a business of a restaurant. Prabhupada is talking about Govindas that time. So then Prabhupada was thinking whether if this is New York is not successful, he'll go to California, or of course he had almost finishing his time. So he October, November, then he has to go back by December, something like that. But he extended his visa till April next year. Then he was waiting for the opportunity. He doesn't know what direction Krishna would give. So there are many letters he has written it to Sally. Even after that, he was keep in touch with them so affectionately. Sally would promptly would return back his letter. And such a thing, Prabhupada had a very wonderful the initial place where they given accommodation to Prabhupada. Because of them, we should be thankful. Because of them, their host, the first host in America, Prabhupada could able to start his mission from this place. So I would stop here for more comments or realization.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji, for such a wonderful visual narrative. It was as if we are completely visualizing his stay in America. Thank you very much. Devotees can unmute themselves to share their reflections, or if they have any questions, they can directly ask Prabhuji.
So meanwhile, questions are coming. I just read one paragraph. As a sannyasi, Srila Prabhupada was used to pick up and leaving one place, picking up and leaving one place for another. As a mendicant preacher, he had no remorse about leaving behind the quiet life of Butler YMCA. And he had no attachment for the domestic habitat where he would cook and talk with Sally Agarwal about vacuum cleaners, frozen foods, and American ways. But why had he gone to Butler and why he was going to New York? He saw it as Krishna's grace. As a pure devotee of Krishna, he wanted to be an instrument for distributing Krishna consciousness. So Prabhupada was never like, you know, attached to anything, one place. When he was in Vrindavan also, we have seen the previous chapters, how Prabhupada used to go to Mumbai for preaching, book distribution, and he will not have any place to say permanent place, then he would, you know, move places to place. So Prabhupada was one determination, like whatever Krishna takes, he's a old person, imagine he eats only one meal and he need to cook vegetarian food and there's nothing available, he doesn't know anybody, and Prabhupada is, you know, just depending on Krishna time to time, and he never compromised, because he wants, with the 2 months time, he said, you know, I want to do something. So he said, let me go to New York. He didn't know anybody in New York, at least here, Butler, Pennsylvania, you know, Gopal, who sponsor initially, they are agreed to, you know, meet him, but otherwise he doesn't know anyone. So Prabhupada was on his own to New York, and Ali was thinking, she was broken actually, literally saying how Prabhupada would survive, because it's cold. He didn't have a coat to wear. Prabhupada did not have any winter warm clothes, and Prabhupada was determined to go.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, I don't have any questions. I wonder, I just admire his determination. I always think I'm late into Krishna consciousness. I think it is better late than never. Hare Krishna Prabhu, Dandavat Pranam. Yes.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna Gaurachandra Gopinath Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Thank you for giving the class the very short notice. Prabhuji, this specific chapter is really touching, especially when Prabhupada stays at Sally's house. You know, he was, you know, very orthodox person, but how he was tolerating. And that was very nice, Prabhuji, this one. Oh, wonderful. And his focus and determination was throughout until you know, he established ISKCON. I think his focus and determination was amazing. I don't know what to say. So touching with this.
Yeah, his letters were so amazing. There are many letters he wrote to Sally. I was keeping in touch, but the way he connects with the people, their life, and you know, it's just like, you know, another member. You see the liberty Prabhupada takes to bless them and says, I'm an old person, I don't have anything to give. I'm a mendicant, you know, amazing. And he appreciates her all the time, saying, I'm also one of your son, elder son, I'm taking adventures, please help me, like that. Prabhupada would connect so well, you know. And he had a big business plan, and he wanted her to be investing in New York so that they can start the mission.
Oh, yeah. I think one thing that was unique to Prabhupada was, though he was 70 years when he was in US, but the way with which he was connecting across all the age group, that was wonderful. Starting from 18 years.
Yeah.
To those young boys and girls, children. That was amazing, Prabhuji.
Look at the place. Very strange. Even from this purport, we can understand nobody has gone before, and it's not usual thing. Like now, people go Harinam and people know Hare Krishna's, like shaven head, it's that kind of robe. Somebody is coming to that place. America is something new. And they never would expect. And as you mentioned, Prabhupada, just everything is opposite. You know, he wants to preach the people, first thing, about the four regulative principle, which was completely is not there. Second thing, he want to connect from his Indian accent, the Bengali heavy accent, to, you know, people, whether would understand or not. then he wants to connect to the age group of 30 and 35. They were 30 and 35 sadly that time. He want to connect to that group. Then he went to, you know, especially New York, you can see the place of hippies where they are against all this culture art, and he wants to preach against that. And everything is like, you know, Prabhupada doesn't know anyone there. And you look at the Prabhupada success, every art he is came against. It's amazing.
Can I say something?
Yeah, please, Prabhu.
Yeah, it was wonderful. You're taking us along with Prabhupada's journey. Thank you very much. Please continue to do so. Also, I would request if any one of the devotees here would like to also narrate Srila Prabhupada's pastimes, the temple very is very eager to engage them. All right? Please, you let us know. We will put you also on the roll. All right? Thank you. You can repeat it, Ma, if they didn't get it.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Prabhu was mentioning that anybody is like to narrate Srila Prabhupada Leelamrita, you can be on the schedule. So you are most welcome to engage in Prabhupada Seva. It's more purifying it. The more the people, more katha, it's more relishable. And please do talk to, you can coordinate with the Sankarshan Priya Prabhu or Sri Gopinath Pran Prabhu. Okay.
Thank you, Prabhuji. And, you know, I just want to share one anecdote. When I was visiting Mexico last year and the previous year, and I could see the seed laid by Prabhupada, because I met one Mexican devotee who was with ISKCON for about last 30 plus years, 35 years. And now, his children and his grandchildren, they are also devotees. So he was narrating how they got attracted by Prabhupada ISKCON. You know, they got attracted through Kirtan. And also when I was heading back to the hotel, the taxi driver, so he was speaking broken English and he was telling about that. And he was asking me, where are you coming from? And then, you know, I asked him, do you know about this place? I just pointed to the temple and I was asking him. He said, yeah, Hare Krishna, yes, I know about that place. And he was explaining, you know, he also went to US where in Los Angeles, he saw these devotees with shaven head and in, you know, orange dress. They were jumping and dancing. I didn't understand, but one thing what I could really see was that they are so happy. They are so happy people, and it's quite rare to see them, and they are very nice people. So that was the type of impression he was sharing. So that's the greatness of Prabhupada. He's laid the seed everywhere across the world. So nice. Thank you, Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, if anyone else would like to share anything?
Prabhu, today what happened, I would like to share with everybody. The book distribution month, I was wondering, so far I could do today how to start. The milk person who delivers the milk, he had come. I didn't ask about Hare Krishna or anything like that. I asked him which language you speak at home, which language you read and all that. Then I asked him, if I give you Bhagavad Gita, will you read? He said, of course, madam. Then usually I don't want to give anybody free. I told him, okay, this book costs 200. You give me 100 rupees, I'll put 100 rupees and then give. He was so happy. I said, thank you, madam. Correct. If I get it free, I just keep it aside. Because I paid, I will read it, he was telling. Yes. Thank you, I told. That's how my day started today.
Jai Srila Prabhupada.
Yes, Prabhu. Yes, Prabhu.
Hari Bol, Mataji.
Yeah, that was very inspirational. Thank you for sharing, Madhi. Okay, Prabhu, I think we can conclude here.
Yeah. Pancha Kalpatra Vaishnava Paditanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Thank you very much. We are concluding the meeting. Hare Krishna.